Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. A job safety analysis, commonly referred to as a JSA, is a procedural document used to prompt workers to review what are the potential hazards and risks involved when carrying out a work task, and how can they be addressed to improve the safety for the people who are carrying out that work task. So conducting a JSA always happens before work starts, and it involves breaking down a specific work task into a series of steps, identifying the potential hazards at each step, and then determining what are the preventative measures that we can put in place to overcome each hazard. And then once that's completed, everyone signs off. And really, by following the JSA process, workers are forced to consider what are the hazards, how to address them, and how are we going to keep everyone safe working on site. So in this video, we're going to look at how Dashpivot can be used to really streamline and standardize the way that job safety analyses are filled out within your organization. So this template for our job safety analysis has already been set up, but no forms have been created just yet. So the first step is to click the green button over here to create a new form. And we've already set up our template. So we've got a section up the top for the JSA details. So we can pop in the date. Maybe we're doing some service locating. We can pop in the area that we're working in. We can add some photos. And this is really handy if we're filling out this job safety analysis on site using the mobile app, on the tablet or on the phone. We can open up the camera, take the photo, add a description, and then hit save when we're done. And that will all get linked in here. And we can continue to make our way down the form, filling out all the relevant details about what equipment is on site, what documentation we need to have. We've got our risk matrix up here, and that's really handy for the real bulk of the form, which is the JSA action steps, which is what we have here. And our action steps have been set up as a table inside of Dashpivot. So that means that we're able to add multiple line items as we need. So we can say, all right, step one, step two, step three, step four, as we go, as many as we need. And then this table has columns for each of the items that we mentioned before. So having details around what the job step is, what are the hazards that are involved, we can refer to our risk matrix up here to give it a risk rating. And then we have the last two columns, how are we going to control it and who's going to be responsible. So we can list out all of this information. And then once we're happy with everything that's being filled out, we can get everyone who's on site to add their signature. So if it was, if we had five people that needed to sign on, we would just click the add manual signature button. It pulls up a modal that's going to ask us who is it and what company do they work for. And then we can add a signature. And then each person can do that and it will stamp that information on this form. And then once we're happy with everything, we can click save. So now we've got our JSA form that has been completed on the 13th of July, sitting here inside of Dashpivot, easy to come back to. And over time, you'll probably end up with something that looks a little more like this, where you've got several records. And these have been stored in a timeline view, which means that everything's stored in chronological order. So we've got the most recent ones up the top, the oldest ones down the bottom, so that makes it really easy to find. But we've also got the register view here. So we can toggle from the timeline view to the register. And what that's doing is it's converting each of our forms into a row. And then we have a column for each of the fields that we had. So we had a field for the date, a field for the work activity, the location, etc. So all of that information is in here. So this makes it really fast to quickly come back and find all of the relevant information that was filled out for each JSA. So in the event that we ever had to come back and find out what was planned and who signed off on everything, this makes it really quick to find stuff, especially when we've got filters. So we can say, show me between, you know, 1st of June to the 30th of June. We could pop that in and pull up all the relevant records for that period of time. And if we need to, we can export these forms out of here as well. So we can make a selection and you'll see that as soon as I click that, these options appear up the top. So we can select individually or we can bulk select everything. And then we've got the option to export this as a CSV. We've got the option to download this register of all of our forms as a PDF, or we can download each individual form as a PDF, and that'll come out with your company logo up the top and all the relevant information about what project it's on and what team it is, who created it, all of that. So it makes it really easy to get the information out and print that out if you need to give that to someone or email it off. So to get started with a JSA template, if you go to the template section, you can click on Add New Template, and you can build your own from scratch if you'd like, but we also have a free JSA template available in the template library, so you can click on that, just search Job Safety Analysis, and it'll come up with a template that you can use to get started. You can always go back in there and modify it, so you can take things out, add new things in, whatever works for you and your organization. And if you need a hand with anything, you can always open up the live chat down here, send a message to our team via this top section here. We can start a new conversation and say hello. Or we can search the knowledge base that we have inside of Dashpivot for different articles explaining the different aspects of Dashpivot. And so that concludes this video. That's really how you can standardize and streamline the JSA process inside of Dashpivot. And I hope that this video has been useful. Thanks for watching.